This is Srinivas Lakhim. Today we are going to discuss constructors in Java. What is constructor? What is constructor? Constructor is a special member method. Constructor is a special member method. Let's see one simple example. I am writing a class A. In this class, if you want to define a name constructor, so constructor name should be class name. Constructor name should be class name. And it doesn't return any value even void. It doesn't return any value even void. Constructor doesn't return any value even void. So constructor name should be class name. It doesn't return value, even any value. Okay, so it is like a method. So you can take method, but any name, but constructor name should be a class name. Next, constructor is executed automatically when we create an object. Assume I am writing one method, public static void main. String array args. So this is my main method. So whenever I create an object, a1 equal to new a, it will automatically calls constructor. So in this constructor, I have one method, I have one statement, system.out.println inside constructor. So when we create an object, this statement specially for calling constructor. New operator create an object. Then this statement calls constructor. So this is calling what? This constructor. Because here we are not passing any arguments, so it will call this constructor. So first it will execute this constructor. And in this constructor, we have only one statement called system.out.println statement. So we get output as inside constructor. See, if you want to call method, we have to call through object reference. But constructor is automatically executed by JVM. When it will execute? Whenever we create an object. Constructor is executed automatically. But method we have to call through the object reference. See, I have a method. This is M1 method. Inside M1. So if you want to call this method, we can call after object creation through the reference, we can call M1 method. So methods we can call explicitly, but constructor is called automatically when we create an object. No need to call constructor explicitly like methods. Constructor is executed automatically when we create an object, because this statement calls automatically constructor. So constructor is executed automatically, but methods we have to call explicitly. Constructor is executed automatically. Okay, see, method we can call any number of times. I want to call method multiple times. So methods we can call multiple times by using object reference. Okay, but how can we call constructor multiple times? So constructor is executed when at the time of object creation. Constructors we cannot call explicitly like methods. So if you want to call constructor again, we need to create one more object. So if you want to call constructor multiple times, you need to create multiple objects. We cannot call constructor explicitly like methods. Okay? One important point is, like methods, we cannot call constructors explicitly. If you want to call constructor, you need to create object. Okay, so like methods we cannot call constructor multiple times. If you want to call constructor, you need to create multiple objects. Okay, then what is the purpose of constructor? See, let's see one simple example. I am writing one class, class A. In this class, I have variable int A, I have one more variable float F, and I have one more variable string S. Okay, and I have one default constructor. One statement called system.out.println inside constructor. So this is my class. I am writing one client class. This is business class. I am writing one class called client class. So I am writing class test. In this test class, I have public, static, void, main, and it takes one argument. So this is my class. In this class, I am creating an object of class A1 equal to new A. So this statement calls what? So this statement creates class A object. So it is creating class A object, and it is calling constructor So in this constructor, we have only one statement called system.out.println inside constructor. So initially we get output is inside constructor. So this statement calls this constructor. Inside this constructor we have only one statement. Constructor is executed. When we create an object, it loads all instance variables into this object. A, we have instance variable A, instance variable F, and instance variable S. So when we create an object, JVM initialize these instance variable with default values. S is a reference variable, that's why it assigns default value is null. So constructor is completed and this object is referenced by A1 reference. See, object variables are initialized with default values. When I print system.out.println a1.a, I will get output of 0. When I print system.out.println a1.f, I will get output of 0.0. When I print system.out.println a1.s, I will get output of null. So it means when we create an object, it automatically calls constructor. After executing constructor, it will assign default values to all variables. So if you call these instance variables, we are getting what? Default values. So if you don't want to assign default values at the time of object creation, if you don't want to assign default values, if you want to assign values, we use constructors. So the main purpose of constructor is to initialize objects. The main purpose of constructor is to initialize objects. So inside constructor we write logics like a equal to 10, f equal to 10.5, f, s equal to Srinivas. So at the time of object creation, if you want to initialize object, we use what? Constructor. So instead of default values, it initialize what? Whatever the values we are initializing in constructor. So it initialize a equal to 10, f equal to 10.5f, s equal to Srinivas. So when you print this variables, we get instead of default values, we are getting what? Actual values. So the main purpose of constructor is to initialize objects. If you not initialize object, what will happen? It automatically initializes default values. So the main purpose of constructor is to initialize objects at the time of object creation. So without initialize, what will happen? By default, JVM assigns default values in your object variables. Instead of default values if you want assign or if you want initialize object variables, then we use constructor. Inside constructor we write statements to initialize our object variables. Okay, types of constructors. First, default constructor. Default constructor. And second one, no argument constructor. No argument constructor. Next one, argument constructor. Argument constructor. So inside a class we have three types of constructors. One is default constructor, and another one is no argument constructor, and next one is argument constructor. You can take argument constructors like one argument, two argument, three argument, n number of arguments. Okay, so we have three types of constructors. Let's see default constructor. What is default constructor? See, if you write any class, class A, class A, this is my Java program. So my program name is a.java, a.java. When I compile this program by using Java C, a.java. So whenever we compile this program, Java compiler reads this source program and first it will check whether this class has constructor or not. So if your class doesn't have constructor, compiler adds one default constructor, so your source code look like this. Class A, and inside this it will add one default constructor. So compiled source code contain what? Default constructor. So what is the default constructor? So default constructor is created by compiler at the time of compilation. So first point is, default constructor is created by compiler at the time of compilation. So at the time of compilation it will create constructor. When it will create default constructor? When compiler creates default constructor. When compiler creates default constructor. Compiler creates default constructor when your class doesn't have any constructor. So example, I have class A. This class doesn't have any constructor. So after compilation you will get what? You will get like this. Compiled source code contained in this form. If your class contain any constructor, then compiler doesn't create default constructor. If your class contain any constructor, compiler doesn't create default constructor. Okay, so if your class doesn't have any constructor, then only compiler creates default constructor. If your class contain at least one constructor, if your class contain at least one constructor, default constructor will not generate. Compiler cannot create what? Default constructor. So this is very very important point. So if your class contain at least one constructor, compiler cannot create default constructor. Default constructor is generated when your class doesn't have any constructor. Okay. Next, what is the purpose of default constructor? What is the purpose of default constructor? We will see the purpose of default constructor in inheritance clearly. So up to that we'll discuss what is default constructor. Okay, so default constructor is created or generated automatically when your class doesn't have any constructor. Okay, next one, no argument constructor. Next one, no argument constructor. So no argument constructor doesn't take any arguments. No argument constructor doesn't take any arguments. In this you can write any number of steps. So here I am writing some statements inside no argument constructor. So if you want to create an object for your class, no need to pass any arguments to this constructor. So I am writing class test. Inside this class I have one method, public static void main method. In this I have one argument string array args. So here, when you create an object to a class with this syntax, so this syntax is calling no argument constructor. So this syntax calls either default constructor or no argument constructor. See, what is the difference between no argument constructor and default constructor? What is the difference between default constructor and no argument constructor? Most of the people confuse with default constructor and no argument constructor, because both no argument constructor and default constructor syntax is similar. If you see no argument constructor, it doesn't take any arguments. If you see default constructor, it also doesn't take any argument. So there is difference. Some people doesn't know what is default constructor and what is no argument constructor. Sometimes they call default constructor, sometimes they call no argument constructor, but there is a difference. See, this no argument constructor is created by whom? Programmer. This no argument constructor is created by programmer, but default constructor is generated by compiler. No argument constructor is created by programmer, default constructor is created by compiler. When default constructor is created? If your class doesn't have any constructor, compiler will create automatically. If your class has at least one constructor, compiler cannot create default constructor. So important rule is, default constructor generated by compiler when your class doesn't have any constructor. But no argument constructor is created by programmer at the time of class development. At the time of class creation, programmer defines no argument constructor. But default constructor is created by compiler when your class doesn't have any constructor. So this is the main difference. Both syntax is different. Both syntax is different. Both syntax is same because no argument constructor doesn't take any argument. Default constructor also doesn't take any argument. Syntax is same, but there is some difference. If I write this class, after compilation you get compiled code is like this. So this is compiler generated code. This is what programmer designed code. So in compiler generated code, default constructor is generated, but here already we have no argument constructor. So what is the difference between default constructor and no argument constructor? If you clearly observe, default constructor doesn't have any statements except one statement. We will discuss that statement later. So in default constructor there are no statements, but inside no argument constructor there may be a statements. If you write statements, that statements are presented in no argument constructors. But in default constructor there is no chance of contain any statements except one statement. That statement is to call its parent. There is only one statement in no argument constructor. We will discuss that statement at the time of inheritance discussion. Okay, so in inheritance discussion we will discuss what is that statement. That statement is presented in every constructor, not only default constructor. For every constructor that statement is presented. Okay, so except that default constructor doesn't have any statements, but no argument constructors may have statements. Okay, next one, argument constructor. So we can take a class. Inside a class you can take argument constructor. So you can take any number of arguments constructor. Inside a class you can take any number of arguments constructor. The main purpose of argument constructor is to initialize objects. So inside this argument constructor we initialize what? X equal to A and y equal to b, and I am writing statement called system.out.println inside argument constructor. So this is my class A and I have client class test. Inside this class there is one statement, public static void main string array. I am trying to create an object to class A like this. A1 equal to new A. Can you guess, is it possible to create an object in this way? Yes or no? Can we create an object to class A in this way? y. This statement is to call constructor, right? This statement is to call constructor. This statement may call default constructor, or it may call what? No argument constructor. No argument constructor, right? When it calls default constructor, when it calls default constructor, if your class doesn't have any constructor, then it will call default constructor. If your class has no argument constructor, it will call no argument constructor. So if your class has no argument constructor, this statement calls only no argument constructor. If your class doesn't have any constructors, then this statement calls what? Default constructor. Okay, so if you see that statement, it is trying to call either default or no argument constructor. But in my class, there is no default constructor. Why? Because we have what? One constructor. If your class has at least one constructor, there is no default constructor concept. Okay, then it is trying to call no argument constructor, but there is no argument constructor in our class. But there is no argument constructor in class. That's why it is not possible to call. So if you want to create an object to your class, you have to call argument constructor, because there is no argument constructor in our class. Present, we don't have any no argument constructor. We have only argument constructor. So if you want to create an object to your class A, you need to create an object by passing arguments to constructor. So how do we create an object to this class? Create an object A to equal to new A and pass arguments. So this statement creates an object. This statement calls constructor by passing two values means it will call this constructor. So in this constructor, what we did? Inside x we assigned 10, inside y we assigned 20. Then after these two statements, there is one more statement called system.out.println printing message. So we get output as inside argument constructor. Okay, did you understand what is argument constructor? So there is no restriction for arguments here. You can take any number of arguments. Okay,